Hello friends and welcome to Geeks for Geeks. In this video, we will be solving job sequencing problem. So, the problem statement given to us is that there are certain number of jobs with each job having a deadline and some profit if it is done before its deadline. Also, it is given that these jobs takes only a single unit of time. We have to schedule these jobs in such a way so as to maximize the total profit. Let's take an example and make this problem statement more clear. Here we have 5 jobs with job ID as A to E. Here job A has to be done before 2 unit time. And if it is done, the profit made would be 100 units. Since each job takes only 1 second to finish, we can schedule A to be from 0 to 1 second or from 1 to 2 second. Similarly, we have to arrange these jobs such that they maximize our profit. Let's look at the answer sequence. We scheduled job C from 0 to 1 second. From 1 to 2 second, we do job A. Now, 2 seconds have passed and our total profit made is 127. Now, only job with a deadline is E. We schedule it from 2 to 3 seconds and then our total profit becomes 142, which is the maximum possible profit. Now think over what we are doing to maximize our profit. We are just selecting the job with maximum profit and scheduling it at latest time that meets its deadline. Nothing is achieved by scheduling it earlier. So the best possible method for it is to use a greedy approach. For this, we have a 3-step greedy algorithm. The first step is to sort the jobs in decreasing order of profit. Next, we schedule the first job from the list of sorted jobs. Then for all the remaining jobs, we schedule it at latest time that meets its deadline. Let's see these 3 steps in action on a sample input. The first step is to sort the jobs in decreasing order of profits. Here we have our input, and after sorting, the table would look like this. Note how our profit row is sorted. In next step, we will schedule our first job from our sorted table. The first job has a deadline of 2 units, so we can schedule it from 0 to 1 second or from 1 to 2 seconds. Now, here the thing to note is that we will try to schedule jobs as late as possible because nothing is gained by scheduling it earlier, and scheduling it earlier could prevent another more profitable job from being done. So, out of the 2 possibilities, we choose the interval 1 to 2 seconds. Now, for all the jobs, we will use the same approach and try to schedule it just before its deadline ends. If some job is already there, we will do it in earlier interval. So, next job is C with a deadline 2. We start looking for a free slot from 2 in opposite direction. This slot 1 to 2 second is occupied by A. So, we choose the earlier slot which is free and schedule C there. Now, the next job is T with a deadline of 1. We start looking for an empty slot from 1. This slot 0 to 1 is already taken, which means we cannot schedule this job. So, we skip it. Next job is B with a deadline of 1. Since there is no empty slot for this deadline, we skip it. Next job is E with a deadline of 3. We start looking for an empty slot from 3. Slot 2 to 3 is empty, so we can schedule it here. Now all jobs are done. So our final sequence is C, then A, and then E. Let's summarize these steps in a form of code. This code is taken from GeeksforGeeks. This function takes an array of struct type job and number of jobs n. We begin by sorting our array. This sort function is from STL, and this comparison function is our custom function which compares two jobs based on its profit. We'll see its definition later. Then we mark all time slot as free. We then iterate over all jobs and try to find a free slot for them. For a slot, we start looking backwards from the last possible slot to the earliest one. Wherever we find an empty slot, we mark it as occupied and break out of this loop. Once we have scheduled the jobs, we print the sequence. Here we have the job structure and comparison function for your reference. Every job has an ID, a deadline, and a profit. This comparison function helps to sort the jobs according to profit. Let's look at the time complexity of this algorithm. This code will run in big O of n square time. Here n are the number of jobs as input. With this, we come to an end of this tutorial. If you have any doubts or suggestions, please leave them in the comment section below. Thanks for watching.